connecting Arizona. This is 12 Views at 5.
A story that you will only see right here on Channel 12. Drunk driving cases could be dropped in Scottsdale. That's because blood testing equipment at the city crime lab possibly wasn't giving accurate readings. According to court documents, the crime lab knew the analyzer had problems but didn't do anything about it. So now the evidence is being tossed out, including at least 11 cases involving felony DUIs. Our own William Pitts is live in Scottsdale with a DUI debacle. Will?
Now, the Maricopa County Attorney's Office filed an appeal on that decision today. 40 pages. It basically challenges everything the judge ruled when he threw out all of that evidence the first time. But this whole case could open up doubt on a lot more DUI cases.
I was surprised that he was putting me through the paces, but I told him I'd had a beer. He probably thought that meant 4 or 5.
Len Syke was arrested, booked, and had his blood drawn. That's his result, 0.11, sandwiched between two zeros.
I'm picturing Joe Arpaio's Tent City, wearing pink underwear on a hot summer day, for something that I'm trying to explain is not right.
Len's lawyer thought those two zeros were a little strange. He thought the results had gotten flipped, that Len's blood was one of the zeros. And that's what he told the jury.
We were able to show how disconnected what they're accusing Len of doing with what was actually seen. And the jury, I think, honestly acquitted on a theory of potential human error.
That was back in 2011. One piece of evidence that led to other lawyers asking questions about the crime lab. Now the same lab that processed Len's blood is under fire for allegedly botching more DUI tests in Scottsdale.
This doesn't happen. We don't see these cases in criminal law often. And the reason is because this is a complete failure of a crime lab.
Blood evidence has since been tossed out in 11 more cases, and the judge in the case wrote a 20-page decision bashing the Scottsdale crime lab. Len's just glad the jury saw things his way.
It makes it even more frustrating to know that flawed equipment and flawed results would, had they been known at the time, may have resolved this without having to go through all of that.
The Maricopa County Attorney's Office had no comment on the case today. Scottsdale Police, though, sent us a statement saying the blood alcohol testing equipment is functioning properly. The machine in question has not had any issues in over 2 years. Our department and the city prosecutor wish to express the highest of confidence in the scientists, procedures, and instruments they use in the Scottsdale lab. Now, the lawyers we talked to said this whole issue with the crime lab could cast a lot of doubt on any other DUI cases for the last 4 years. Live in Scottsdale, William Pitts, 12 News.
William, thanks.